This video explains how to navigate around the topology map page. The topology map is the default landing page when we log into the ROA web interface. We can use it to view our network topology, see the status of our network devices and links, and drill down into specific device or link information. We can use the icon on the right-hand side to select the topology. We can choose which topology we want to observe and which details of the topology to display. In the topology dropdown, we can choose from a list of topologies. The preloaded topology section may be available if our administrator enables it. This section is where an administrator can make important topologies readily available. The details portion of the topology selection window enables us to choose which parts of the topology to load. Omitting certain parts of the topology can help us save system resources. For example, in a multi-AS network, a network operator that is handling one AS does not need the information from all other AS networks in order to troubleshoot issues of their own AS. In the center of the page, we see the current topology map. The map shows a layer 3 view of the network. Each device represents a router, and each topology link represents a layer 3 connection or adjacency between the routers. Clicking on a network device or a link opens an inspector window. The inspector window shows summary information, such as routing protocols, events, and device or link status. While the inspector window is open, we can reposition the device in the topology. If we press and hold the device icon on the topology, we can move it somewhere else. If we select Drill In, we will be brought to the context page for that device or link. Context pages provide comprehensive performance graphs and minimaps for specific devices, links, interfaces, paths, and services. The Path Search tool is at the upper left corner. By entering a starting point and destination, we highlight the forward and reverse path between the selected endpoints. We can also enter only a starting point if we want to find a router in a complex network. After typing a few characters, a pick list appears. Clicking on a name will complete the starting point and mark the device in the topology. The Top Map Control button resets the zoom and position of the map. Below the Zoom Reset button is the Toggle Path Opacity button. Pressing this button reduces the opacity of the whole map, except for the selected path. It makes the path stand out more for easier visualization during a path playback, for example. Pressing the Toggle Links button hides all links on the topology map. We can zoom in or out of the topology map with mouse scroll, or we can use the map control buttons Zoom In and Zoom Out at the lower right corner of the map. At the bottom right are the map customization tools. Here, we can choose if the links are colored based on utilization, IGP area, or not colored. We can also enable additional link labels that are shown on the map. Labels such as utilization, metric, latency, capacity, input and output errors, or configured delay are available. These labels are shown next to the links that they belong to. Colors and labels can be used in combination. For example, we can see if increased latency is due to high utilization on each link. The tool menu is next to the time selection tool. Once the map is laid out the way we like it, we can save the current layout. Make it the default topology layout when logging in. We can delete the layout, open a different layout for current network topology, or we can roll back layout changes with the Relayout option. Enabling the Toggle Geographic Map option adds a geolocation map background to the topology and groups network devices based on their geographic location. The Toggle Grouping option joins or separates the network devices that are densely grouped together. The group icon displays the number of devices it represents. The Hide Leaf Node option hides network nodes that are only connected with a single link. This is used to simplify a complex network with a lot of single attached routers, allowing easy visualization of the core of the network. Hide Failed Nodes hides unavailable nodes from the network topology. While routers that are down will eventually time out from the topology, it can be useful to remove them here if we are making large changes to the network. The Show All Nodes displays all hidden nodes on the network topology. Choosing the Toggle Legend option displays the Map Legend window. Icons that represent different types of nodes and links are described here. If we click and hold on a specific icon, all devices or links that are represented by this icon are highlighted on the topology map. The Path Playback tool is located at the bottom of the page. Here we can observe network changes through time, specified in the Time Selection tool. In this example, we can see the network latency changes and path changes of the highlighted path. This concludes the topology map overview.